Imagine running several successful business accounts, reaching thousands of people, and then your Instagram profiles get suspended. Sounds like your worst nightmare, right? Well, hang on as I share how to prevent this and manage multiple Instagram profiles using proxies. But what exactly are proxies? Well, Instagram proxies are servers that stand between you and the social media platform. They act as a middleman and lend you a unique IP address tied to a specific location. Now, unlike regular ones, Instagram proxies are optimized for a particular social network and give you complete anonymity. Sounds really good on paper, right? But are they actually useful? Well, Instagram allows up to 5 accounts per one IP address. And if you don't follow the rules, your profiles are prone to be blocked, but luckily a proxy service lends its IP pool, so each IP address opens extra slots for 5 Instagram accounts. You can do the math yourself. With proxies, you can also forget about automation struggles. See, whenever you're logged into Instagram, it tracks the user's behavior and browsing history. The platform takes extreme measures against so-called spamming. Now, for example, mass liking looks very innocent at first glance, but each like sends a request to Instagram servers. And when you surpass set activity limits for one IP address, and in this case, 1,000 likes per day, accounts again are doomed for suspension. Though by changing IPs, automation like this is less likely to be flagged as fishy. Proxies also handle geo-targeting. Now, Instagram's explore page algorithm recommends content by relevant interests and proximity. So when you pick an IP address from, let's say, a particular city, posts pop up more for the chosen city residents. Now, the best thing is most proxy service providers offer precise geo-targeting, so make sure to take full advantage of this great feature. Now, I know you're probably thinking, all right, I see the buzz about social media proxies, just tell me how to use them already. Well, it all starts with choosing the right kind of proxies. I'd recommend a service optimized for Instagram like residential or mobile proxies. Just stay away from data center ones. They have low subnet diversity compared to residential IPs, so they are likely to stand out among legit users and then get detected. Nowadays, some providers market their Instagram proxies as virgin. A virgin proxy suggests that it hasn't been used before. Now, in theory, it's ideal for multiple accounts management, because if a proxy is brand new, then there's no chance it's been flagged before, yet you can hardly find unused residential proxies. So rather than aimlessly looking for virgin proxies, stick to clean IPs, addresses that have been used but not blacklisted on Instagram. A large proxy pool usually ensures more clean IPs. It also offers more precise geo-targeting since you have more IPs to pick from, so that's a win-win situation. Pay attention to network uptime too. Connection issues are annoying and put your multiple accounts at risk, and this is because Instagram sees ongoing network errors as suspicious behavior. So to prevent this, aim for a short response time and high success rate, as close to 100% as possible. By the way, we also reviewed the best Instagram proxies. Feel free to check out our recommendations. You'll find the video here and in the description. When you finally get your proxies, assign no more than 4 accounts to a single IP. So why not 5? Well, it's like a safety blanket, just in case anyone has been using the same IP for their Instagram accounts. You should also opt for longer sticky sessions and pay attention to the IP address location. For example, if an Instagram account is typically run, let's say in the USA, don't randomly switch it to Japan. It'll mess up your content geo-targeting and raise a red flag to the platform. Consistency is key. And from then on, more factors like browser fingerprinting or bot quality do come into play. For maximum security, combine proxies with anti-detect browsers and high-quality bots. Warm up your accounts and authenticate them too, if possible. But more on that on our multiple accounts management playlist. Watch that for in-depth social media tips. That's what I've got for you this time. I'll see you in the next video.